I was taking my afternoon nap a couple of hours ago, and I got a surprise, a very nice surprise. It was this report from one of my patients. You know how I often say, look, you should have a dip in the late night, early morning hours in your blood sugar. And people that say, I'm just going to check my blood sugar using finger stick, are just usually not going to get this information. As you can see, this individual goes down to around 60 at midnight. These are average of several days. This goes down to 60 at midnight, 58 at 3 a.m., 61, and then 65 about 9. Now he's got an eating window of about 6 hours, 4 to 6 hours, starting at noon. And you can see what happens in terms of his blood sugar values. He said, here's what happens. They go from 77 up to 92, and that's where they peak out. Now, that's very interesting. I can tell you, a lot of people with full-blown diabetes have reports and numbers like this from doing two things. Number one, managing their eating window, like this individual. And number two, most importantly, watching their carbs. So if you'd like to get more information on how to Freestyle Libre prescription, how to get metformin, how to help deal with your prediabetes, diagnose your prediabetes, just give us an email at myhealth@prevmedheartrisk.com. Thank you very much for your interest. If plaque is the number one cause of heart attack, stroke, dementia, blindness, kidney disease, you'd think we'd know how to evaluate it, screen for it, wouldn't you? Unfortunately, the state of the art right now is a guess, and a bad one at that, Framingham. The most common thing that you do is you say, well, hey doc, why don't we do a stress test? They don't work either. Then you go into the cath lab and get a definitive test, but that involves getting a needle in the groin. It just goes downhill from there. Now, there are better ways. Take a look at our plaque evaluation course. Click the link below.